And we'd like to welcome those of you who just watched Oklahoma State defeat LSU in Maui here in Kansas City. Dan Schulman, Dick Vitale, and Doris Burke with you. Number one UCLA up on Maryland, 11-2 early after that last bucket by Nikola Dragovic.
Dragovic, he could shoot the basketball.
Maryland struggling offensively, to say the least. They finally get their second field goal of the game. It's good for Osby, but then they get beaten at the other end by Josh Schiff. Schiff's going to get teed up, and rightfully so.
Well, for celebrating, for being a little hot dogish, but I'm telling you, what about the explosiveness? The high rising, unbelievable jam. There's a look at Ben Holland. He's done a great job defensively with this club, brought physicality to UCLA, and a sense of pride. Oh, up, up, and away. A little jam on a little hot dog in that, a little showboat. Gonna tee him up, Mr. Schulman, gonna tee him up.
So Eric Hayes goes to the line now for Maryland. Maryland with just two field goals in 7 minutes and 35 seconds. Schiff coming back after summer hip surgery. He's now had surgery on both hips in the last 2 years. Certainly look healthy enough on that play.
I'll tell you, injuries have really run rampant with UCLA. Collison not in the lineup. One of the real outstanding point guards in America. Michael Roll, an outstanding shooter, not in the lineup. I'll tell you, when they get their full complement, they're going to be a deep, talented basketball team.
Russell Westbrook, number zero, starting for the injured Collison there on the right of your screen. He's got a bruised left knee. Ben Howland hopes to have him back in about 10 days. They've got some games coming up in the next couple of weeks against George Washington and Texas.
I think for Maryland to be successful, Vasquez and Gist have to be super.
Milbourne, a miss inside, and another strong rebound for Kevin Love, who is a good rebounder, a great passer. There's a carry on Westbrook. As we take a look now at our Star Watch, brought to you by Progressive, and we begin with Kevin Love, the freshman you have read and heard so much about, and he's off to a terrific start in his first three games, albeit against weaker competition than they'll face the rest of the way. James Gist, a senior forward for Maryland, had a huge game and an overtime win over Northeastern a few days ago. Wide open and laying it in is Gravis Vasquez, the 6'6 sophomore out of Venezuela.
Very experienced player. Had really a solid year last year for the Terp.
Maryland will press, and it'll result in a turnover right here. That's going to be a key component of this game. Gist up and under.
Nice reverse layup by Gist. So athletic, so explosive. I tell you, don't go as far as Gist and certainly Vasquez go. They need a solid year out of both guys. If they are not on their A game, they got no shot against great competition. Take a look at this up and under move.
And I'm back here with the Sprint Center at Kansas City. Brand new building. First sporting event in this building. And a brand new number one. UCLA co-number one as of today's poll with North Carolina taking on Maryland in the first semifinal here with the O'Reilly Auto Parts CBE Classic. Now, just when you joined us, you saw the dunk by Josh Schiff. As amazing as that dunk was, Dick, it might not have been the most amazing dunk in this game already.
I know, early in the game. Take a look at this one right here. Are you kidding me? He's flying down the lane, up, up, and away. They lose so much, though, losing to Beckway, and they lost Strawberry. Yeah. They won 25 games last year, had a great win in the first round over a good Davidson team, then lost to Butler by three. Butler's got solid guards. A.J. Graves and Green both are back. Little trap.
And they get another turnover. The pressure from Maryland is having an effect on UCLA. Vasquez misses a three, and the long rebound of Russell Westbrook filling into the point for Darren Collison.
He's a good athlete.
Second field goal for Dragovic.
Tell you, that's a big lift if Dragovic makes that perimeter shot. I think UCLA is going to see pressure because of the lack of point guard play without Collison.
Timeout on the floor. UCLA up six on Maryland.
Back in my day, we didn't have college basketball video games with maximum passing. Actual defensive controls. And a home crowd that gives you a six-man advantage.
Hold on. Back in your day, you're 19. You just look like you're 40.
The number one seeded college basketball video game is back and better than ever with new features that make the game more fun, no matter what age you really are. School's in session. College Hoops 2K8, rated E for everyone.
Sunday, inside America's prisons, drugs, gangs, and riots plague the system. So are prisons making criminals even worse?
We're creating monsters.
Released back on the streets, they've got all the gang and drug contacts they need.
They're going to commit violence because why wouldn't they?
They're stronger, meaner, and more connected. Is this what we had in mind? Prison Nation. Premieres Sunday at 8 on Nat Geo, Channel 276.
Now you can enjoy music on your iPod with Bose Quality Sound, delivered by a small, elegant system that's portable. Introducing the new Bose SoundDock Portable Digital Music System. Unplug it and take it where you want to go for a performance unmatched by other battery-powered systems this small. So while your surroundings may change, the performance stays with you. The new Bose SoundDock Portable Digital Music System. Performance that's portable.
Welcome to ESPN's Feast Week, presented by Lowe's.
Welcome back to Kansas City. Dan Shulman and Dick Vitale with you. Number one of the nation, UCLA up 15-9 on Maryland with the addition of Kevin Love. How good can this team be this year?
Oh, I think they're going to be super, especially when they get Collison back. Collison gives them that jet, ultra quickness, one of the premier point guards in America. And don't forget Michael Roll. He's a guy that can shoot the basketball as well.
And a 6'8 sophomore, James Keefe, a big guy who's going to get some minutes when he gets healthy as well. For more on the Bruins, let's go to Doris Burke.
Well, Dan, one of the early themes of this college basketball season is the emergence of freshman stars on teams that have a history of success. Kevin Love replaces a two-year starter on back-to-back Final Four teams for UCLA, Lorenzo Madariaga. When I asked him about the delicacy of that situation, he simply said, listen, I came here with the expectation of playing a major role and playing a leadership role. He's an unusual guy. For Maryland, because of that passing ability you talked about, Dick, they're going to try to take away his angles. That falls to Bombali Osby. Look for him on the catch to make him shoot over the top. We'll see how it goes, guys.
And Doris, we can tell you from being at shoot-around today, as the Terps inch a little bit closer, that Kevin Lovdick was the most vocal player at practice today for UCLA. He's an outgoing guy. He's comfortable with the media. And maybe it's because his dad played big-time basketball at the collegiate and pro level, but he's more comfortable in the spotlight than a lot of incoming freshmen. Can't get the shot up and over the defense of Maryland right there.
Well, he's been around now.
Gist in the corner out there with Vasquez, Milbourne, Hayes, and a big man in the middle, Braxton Dupree, a 6'8", 260-pound freshman from Baltimore who's going to bang around down low with Kevin Love.
Well, they got to get some minutes out of him. They got to have some people off that bench help him.
Milbourne a miss and another rebound for Love, his sixth already, seventh make it in this game. He's got more rebounds than Maryland does as a team.
Well, he does a great job getting good position. Watch him in a post. If they double him up, he will find the open man.
He is more skilled than athletic, but he's also physical. He seems at times to seek out the contact. Vasquez ahead of the defense for the jam.
Tell you, Maryland really has regrouped. Gary Wins is such a fighter. You watch him on that sideline. Look at the passion, the unbelievable spirit.
And again, here comes the pressure, and it has already forced some early turnovers.
We told you we're going to see pressure. I mean, they're going to see a lot of that pressure playing without a true point guard. See, Roll can also play back there. There's a turnover right there.
Let's take a look now at tonight's lineups brought to you by Sonic. Ben Howland did not like that call. Josh Shipp in the backcourt, a wing guy for UCLA, another hip surgery in the summer, but playing, looking like he's going to have a very big year. And James Gist, a senior forward, coming off a 27-point game for Maryland against Northeastern a few days ago, as Dick mentioned, is a huge key to the Terps' hopes this year. By the way, that was the eighth turnover committed by UCLA already in this game, and four or five of them a direct result of that full-court pressure by the Terps. Vasquez again, looking for the foul, didn't get it, airballed the three.
See, I think he tries to make things happen that aren't available.
And at the other end, Shipp, no goaltending, play on, rebound Terps.
Terps coming over two nail biters, two games you'd have thought they would have blown out the competition, Northeastern and Hampton. But now the level of comp so much higher, and you start to see kids play with a little bit more of an edge. Yep.
The Northeastern game was not one to do with this tournament. They beat North Florida and then Hampton to get here. UCLA beat Youngstown State and a Division II team Cal State San Bernardino to get here. Earlier had a win against Portland State, so obviously this is a big step up for them as Lorenzo Monterreal comes up with a block. Monterreal back in for Love in the middle between the two of them. They may play together every now and again, but generally they will share the center spot.
See, Dan, right now I don't think you see the true rhythm that you're going to see out of UCLA when Collison's on the floor. Remember, he's a terrific three-point shooter, so that spreads the defense even a little bit more. I should look at Collison. Told me before the game, he said, I'm not going to rush, Dickie V. I'm not going to rush. I don't blame him.
Hoping to be back for the George Washington game on the 28th. If not, Ben Howland wants him back for Texas December the 2nd. A bruised left knee suffered a couple of weeks ago.
How about some bad luck for Louisville? Oh. David Padgett looks like he'll be out for the entire year. Was supposed to be a minor injury. It's being reported that he may be out for the entire season.
A knee injury for Padgett. Ship with a tough turnaround in traffic.
He's got great scoring ability, Ship. So athletic, so quick.
At the other end, Cliff Tucker, a freshman from El Paso, number 24, is into the game for Maryland. The first four players off the Terp bench are all freshmen. Here's another one in Adrian Bowie. And we have an offensive foul going on Braxton Dupree, another one of those Maryland freshmen. UCLA by four earlier. We're going to tell you a little bit more about one of the big events going on in Kansas City, the Gallery of Honor inside the National Collegiate Basketball Hall of Fame.
That means better parts, better people, and better prices are just around the corner. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices.
In the old days, shopping for car insurance meant going to company after company, filling out form after form, and getting quotes one at a time. Today, you go to one place, Progressive.com. You get the Progressive Direct rate plus those other companies' rates in about 8 minutes. It's that simple. Start at Progressive.com and get all the information you need to make the best decision in about 8 minutes. Go to Progressive.com today.
An ode to the Subway feast. Turkey, salami, cheese with roast beef, pepperoni and ham. Write this down, Chief. We got them all on freshly baked bread. The Subway feast. It's as big as my head. Subway, eat fresh.
What day is it?
Sir?
So I haven't missed it.
Today, everyone gets a rear seat entertainment system. And to you, a rear seat entertainment system.
And one for you, and one for you, and one for you, young boy.
This holiday season, lease the all-new 2008 XC70 crossover and get a complimentary rear seat entertainment system.
Hearty taste, naturally nutritious. Planters, instinctively good.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts at better prices every day. And Sprint. The O'Reilly Auto Parts CBE Classic is rated for sprint speed. Sprint.
This ESPN2 telecast is available in high definition on ESPN2 HD, presented by Olivia. We're inside the brand new and beautiful Sprint Center here in Kansas City. This is the first athletic event to take place in this building. They've had some concerts here, but no athletic events. And we're right next door to the CBE, the College Basketball Experience, which encompasses, among other things, the National Collegiate Basketball Hall of Fame, a beautiful facility.
Oh,
you and
gorgeous.
I have both gone through there, and it is terrific. Some very interactive parts for the younger fans, and if you've got a sense of history of college basketball, it is it's a great Hall of Fame, and really nice that after so many years of having just one Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame, in it to complement that, there's a facility here in Kansas City that focuses purely on college basketball.
Yeah, that's all. It's a compliment. It's not taking anything away, certainly, from the Naismith, but it's a compliment. And I thought last night. All you UCLA followers will be so proud of the unbelievable job done by Mr. Walton and certainly Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in his acceptance speech. I thought Bill and Lenny Elmore, our colleague, did a great job introducing Lefty Driesell, and it was a terrific night. Enjoyed speaking at it, and it was just a phenomenal night. 3 hours, but I'll tell you, it was worth it to see the Austin Carrs, Dick Groats, Lefty Driesell, Storm and Norman, Mr. Stewart, Clutch, Vic Bubis, and all these people being honored was just really special because they've been so vital to the college game. Dick Barnett, former Tennessee State superstar, he was a poet.
Josh Shipp has gone to the bench with his second foul as Ben Howland has had to go deeper into his bench. Chase Standback, a 6'8 freshman from L.A., number 22 into the game for the first time. Dragovic is back. He's had a couple of early field goals. Love inside, going right at Osby. Montreal with a rebound and a putback.
Montreal's the guy that started last year, as Doris said. Now coming off the bench, buys into the team concept with Love starting. Love, whose uncle, by the way, Beach Boys superstar.
That's right, Michael Love is his uncle.
Love that Beach Boy music. Love that Beach Boy music.
You got a little California, even though you're from Jersey California. Originally, you got a little California in you.
A nice move in the post.
Well, maybe it was a nice move because he used that off arm, that swim move to get around the defender, but he got nabbed.
Just that 27 and a win over Northeastern. Osby was 1-for-9, but he went 14 for 20.
Here
take a look at these people.
You were talking about.
Yes, sir. Guy Lewis. Let me tell you, one of the great speeches, Guy Lewis, you would be so proud. The way you were represented, guy who's battling a stroke for the last 5 years, he was represented by Reed Geddes, who I thought was so impressive representing Houston and his former coach.
Of course, Norm Stewart going in drew a huge ovation here. We're in Kansas
Missouri
City.
Yeah,
Columbia's just a couple of hours up the road. And Columbia, in our second game tonight against Michigan State on ESPNU in the second semifinal. Good screen there by Montreal. Dragovic open for three. Follows his miss, and a fresh 35. They're not going to use him, though, as Standback misses.
Standback had the wide-open shot from the three. Hey, you take a look at the Pac-10. I was talking to Ben before the game. I mean, there's seven dynamite teams. Wait till Stanford gets Brooke Lopez back. He's got to get himself to go to class and understand the importance, especially at Palo Alto. But Lopez will be such a special player, and what an addition to that team.
Oregon is very strong again. USC is going to be a force to be reckoned with. Hayes all the way, and it rims out. Another rebound for Love, and he starts the break for the Bruins. Westbrook. What a move by Russell Westbrook.
He made a great move right there. Almost looked a little bit like our guy we saw from Memphis, Mr. Rose.
That's right. Well, here are the top five in the media poll preseason in the Pac-10. Of course, Washington State had such an incredible year a year ago. Oregon, Arizona, and Stanford rounding up the top half.
You know what's amazing? That doesn't include Southern Cal. Southern Cal went on the road. Daniel Hackett comes back. How's this for a rival coming back from an injury? A triple-double, 22, 10, and 10. And Mr. Mayo had 29.
And for Hackett, after losing about 20 pounds with a broken jaw, UCLA leading Maryland by 7.
See, I think Hackett, he's going to make my, get me some publicity, baby, along with Raymar Morgan, who we'll see in the second game. Spates down of Florida. Hey, I'll tell you one thing. Florida is going to be better than people believe. They just blew out Rutgers by 25. Spates is going to be terrific for them on the inside.
Another turnover. Both teams have been turnover prone here in the first half.
That's
again, more pressure.
Can't lob that ball up. Sloppy. UCLA sloppy against the pressure.
And fortunate to retain possession. This is where Collison will help once he comes back. A big job for Westbrook against the pressure of Maryland.
As I look at Darren Collison, terrific point guard, one of the best, along with Neitzel, we'll see in the next game, and Ty Lawson, and Sean Singletary, who went on the road and got a big win for Virginia against Arizona, had 24 for Dave Lato.
Bamute looking inside, Kevin Love. Montreal working hard for everything underneath. But he misses the putback. A for effort. He just couldn't finish.
Yeah, didn't square his body with the basket.
Hayes can't get the shot off against a larger defender in Mbamute. Mbamute playing more of a small forward spot this year rather than power forward. Gist made that shot tougher than it needed to be.
He really should have taken it with his right hand, used the left hand, falling away.
Maryland's got about 4 minutes in scoring, their second long drought already in this first half.
UCLA trying to show some patience against the Maryland defense.
Westbrook, Montreal baseline jumper, and Montreal's more of a scrapper and garbage type guy around the rim. Three on two, Maryland. Osby can't handle the pass.
A three on one, got a trailer.
Stand back to Westbrook, and a block is the call.
All you got to do is communicate and transition there, flip it over the shoulder, and you got a dunk.
Let's go to Doris Burke now with more on Russell Westbrook. Doris?
Well, guys, a major trend in college basketball, the Mohawk, or in college athletics in general. This one, a bit unique. It's called the Flaming Mohawk. It's actually got a basketball with some flames coming off it. Now, perhaps we can get Greg Garber to now do the Flaming Mohawk. He did a story on it at ESPN.com. That'd be courageous.
Tell you one thing, he was teasing me before the game. You saw it there with the warm-ups. I said, why can't I get a hairstyle like
you
that?
You know, most guys have the right to tease us, but I'm not sure he's one of them with a Flaming Mohawk. But you and I don't have the option of that hairdo anymore. We've got a timeout on the floor, a low-scoring first half, a turnover-prone first half, and maybe we're seeing the effects, Dick, of both teams taking a step up in competition for the first time this year.
Well, you're on the road as well, trying to be impressive, playing, like, as you look at UCLA, the rhythm not there. You're playing without your point guard, your super point guard. You look at Maryland, they got some solid guards. Hayes and Vasquez have to be effective for Maryland to be effective. They got back in the game, they struggled out of the gate. The trap defensively has really bothered UCLA.
Yeah, and both teams have missed a lot of layups around the rim, too. Otherwise, their offensive numbers might look a little bit better. Feast Week presented by Lowe's continues with the EA Sports Maui Invitational. It's on ESPN with a doubleheader tomorrow night. First at 7 Eastern, Marquette will take on Oklahoma State. Those two teams victorious a little bit earlier today at Maui. And then it's the winner of Princeton and Duke taking on the winner of Arizona State and Illinois. Maui is loaded as it always is.
You know, talking about Collison, outstanding point guard, Marquette certainly with Dominic James. And there are three guys on a perimeter, Tom Crean ever outstanding when you talk Matthews, McNeil and James.
Forced to be reckoned with in the Big East, no doubt. The lead up to 9 now for the Bruins. The co-number one as of today with North Carolina.
Nice drive.
Tough driving layup by Gravis Vasquez.
You know, he had 9 in the first half against the USA team. He said to me, no, I played against Kobe Bryant.
He could make the spectacular play. He's been turnover prone early this season, and Gary Williams wants him to slow down a little bit and make some better decisions, but he knows how talented the youngster is.
Well, he had 15 turnovers in the first 3 games, and the reason, Dan, he's trying to make plays because he's trying to help his club. They're a little limited personnel-wise, and he's trying to take some action. Gary's such a fighter on that sideline. We've seen that for years.
Alfred Aboya called for the foul. Ben Hallen doesn't like the call, and we're headed to a timeout on the floor with UCLA up Maryland 22-15.
That means better parts, better people, and better prices are just around the corner. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices.
What kind of question is that? I'm telling you, the Eastern Conference is actually not a JV league. Anybody could come out the East. The West is not dominant anymore, man. There's parity in the NBA right now. You look at Boston, Chicago, Detroit, Orlando, New Jersey, Cleveland, the New York Knicks. We all know there's power in the West. But you got to pay attention now to the East, too, Mello.
I'm just talking about the exit, man. East or West?
Oh.
ESPN, your NBA destination for games Wednesdays and Fridays, plus in-depth analysis all week.
Ferocious Fernando Vargas and Ricardo El Matador Mayorga are two boxers who love to fight. The bad blood is still fresh from the last time they met. Now, the street fight moves to the ring on Friday, November 23rd.
Unbelievable! What a fight!
Vargas versus Mayorga, the brawl. Don't miss it. Friday, November 23rd, live on DirecTV pay-per-view. Vargas versus Mayorga on Channel 123.
Go on an NBA road trip with NBA League Pass. From coast to coast, follow your favorite out-of-market teams and players. In the West, ride along with Steve Nash and the high-octane Suns. Travel across the country and watch the new-look Celtics in the East. See the stars of the Sunshine State, Dwayne Wade and Dwight Howard. Experience the intensity of NBA basketball at home or online with NBA League Pass Broadband. Get NBA League Pass from DirecTV for just $179. To order, call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or visit DirecTV.com.
Scott Reese in the studio, coming up on the Dick's Sporting Goods Halftime Report. We look ahead to Duke, Princeton, and Maui. How good are the Devils? We know how good this guy is. More hardware for Alex Rodriguez as he takes home his third MVP award. And as expected, Lloyd Carr is out at Michigan. Big Sports News Day. We'll have it all for you with Doug Gottlieb and Tom Brennan coming up just a few minutes from now. Dan?
And it's always news, Scott, if a number one loses, not to say that UCLA will. We got a long way to go, and they're up 7 right now. But a Gary Williams and his outstanding career as a head coach has 6 career wins against number one teams, 5 of them as the head coach of Maryland. I would assume North Carolina Duke.
I mean, he gets that chance.
He gets to play number ones a fair bit.
You know, think about this last year. He beat Duke twice. He beat North Carolina. They were 3-6. They won 7 in a row. They go 10-6 in conference play. They win 25 games. I mean, he got them to regroup. They were struggling at 3-6. Take a look at Kevin Love. We're going to watch it right now. Team defense. See him rotate. Look at him rotate over. He rotates over into help position. He anticipates. He has such a great understanding of the game. I think his dad certainly helped that. Stan played in the NBA, was drafted first round by the Washington Bullets.
Kevin is from Oregon. His dad, Stan, played at Oregon, but Kevin opted to go to UCLA, and he's considered one of the best passing big men that we have seen in many, many years. There's a travel on Osby, who's been a turnover machine so far. Let's get more on Love from Doris.
I had a chance to talk to Bill Walton, who has drawn comparison. Kevin Love has drawn comparisons to the great center at UCLA. I asked him what was most impressive. He said, one, he's got an intuitive sense of how to play for a young man. More importantly, an intuitive sense of how to compete. He did, however, as you see, Mike Love, famous Beach Boy, and Stan Love, the father, he objected, or at least was a bit disconcerted, that there is a relaxed nature to the facial hair rules at UCLA, guys.
I'll tell you this right now. He is no 6'10". I know I got one eye. I say he's about 6'8¾". If we measured him, maybe with shoes on a little bigger, but I'm telling you, he can play. I don't care about his size. He has a great understanding how to play the game, great feel for the game. And he's the best big man they've recruited in many a year. And what a class. If you think this is good, the Wizard of Westwood, John Wooden, will love the class they're bringing in next year.
Osby blocks the attempt by Westbrook. Shot clock violation back to the Terps.
How to bring it in Drew Holiday. Remember that name? He is incredible. 6'4 player from out of North Hollywood. Drew Gordon coming in at 6'8". People rate their class maybe number one in the country. Jeremy Anderson, Malcolm Lee.
Well, Dick, you know, one of the interesting things about Love, too, is the relationship he has established with the Wizard of Westwood, John Wooden. They met during a recruiting visit, and they have continued their relationship. And Kevin Love will pick up the phone and call John Wooden and ask him questions about Bruins basketball, about life, about anything.
I know Randy Katz is in the house, and he's the guy to put that story together. I mean, how lucky is that that you got the phone number for John Wooden to get the philosophy that he can share to help you with life?
There's a foul from behind, and
I'll tell you one thing. Hey, Andy, tell us a little bit about Coach Wooden and what happened with Kevin Love.
Well, it actually started in the previous June, when Kevin Love was on a recruiting visit. He met with John Wooden, and it continued after that. When I was with Kevin Love at UCLA, getting a jumper like that, you know, he said that he wanted to call up John Wooden as much as possible to basically sponge in as much information to see what it was like for Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and Bill Walton. What kind of workers were they? And when I talked to John Wooden about it, that's what impressed him the most. I asked him, how often had a UCLA player actually called you up? He says, after he retired, a couple times. Recently, not at all. When I asked Darren Collison the same question, have you ever called John Wooden? He said, no.
Here's his last hoop. I don't know if John Wooden helped him out with his stroke on the three, but for a big guy
who can shoot
and pass the ball like that, he's a weapon.
Let me just say this for Coach Wooden. He would have been so proud last night, and I mean that sincerely, listening to Bill Walton talk about Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, and Kareem was just beautiful, talking about how he would never trade his days for UCLA, saying how young kids have made so many mistakes to leave school. She's got a palm and leave school early. He said, at UCLA, I learned how to really learn about life while I was a student before I headed to the NBA.
Nobody knows how long Kevin Love will hang around. A lot of players now, the top ones, the studs, are one and done these days, so remains to be seen the likes of Kevin Love and O.J. Mayo and Derrick Rose and so forth, but we'll enjoy them while we can and watch them mature. Vasquez right into the traffic, misses a layup.
Well, he did a great job of the curl move. Good offensive rebound. You know, Dan, following up on a point you just made, every kid's situation is different. You can't blame a young guy like Durant and Odin with the money that's available. I mean, you just can't blame those kids.
It was Braxton Dupree with a bucket. Mbamute gets out of the trap. A deep three won't go down for Westbrook, but Mbamute with an offensive rebound. Westbrook going right at the rim, and he's fouled by Shane Walker.
UCLA doing a good job now with the pressure. They got an extra passer, and that they can utilize Love. Try that jam. Interesting to see later on if Memphis hooks up with UCLA in tournament time. Memphis with those phenomenal. I was so impressed with their wings. Chris Douglas Roberts, CDR, causes people to have CPR and need CPR. And also Antonio Anderson are just terrific. And we certainly, Derrick Rose, wow, just in another league.
And we can see even at the elite college basketball level, the Memphis, the UCLA teams are still finding their way. Exactly. They're still establishing roles and so forth.
Hey, what about this for a freshman start? Michael Beasley, you ready? Is averaging 30 and 20. 30 and 20. I was talking to Gary about that. Gary said, let me tell you, he can flat out play.
We'll have a great Jimmy V in a couple of weeks in New York. We'll see Kansas State taking on Notre Dame and Memphis against USC. Turnaround jumper not there for Gist, and Love with yet another rebound.
See, he's a great position rebounder. He's not going to beat you with the spectacular leaping in the sky, but he's an excellent position rebounder.
Number 9 already tonight for Love.
There's some patience offensively, taking the clock down.
Yeah, they can run it right down,
to
0.
For the last shot. Discipline. Two solid coaches on the sidelines. Two guys that know how to win.
Dragovich. Three is a little bit short. Ball still alive. Still got time on the clock here. And UCLA will have a chance for another attempt.
See, take a look at him right here, how he gets good position. Watch Love on the inside. See, he's going to get great position. Shot goes up. Look at him. Look at him blocking out. You see that rear arm. Guys, don't black out. It's not about how high. Most rebounds you get below the rim. You don't get them way up above. And you make that great, great, spectacular play. And in the meantime, three other times, guys sneak in for offensive rebounds.
That's true.
Thanks, Dan. You're going to give me some love.
There you go. There. Oh. Dragovich again.
Scorer, what instincts. That's pure instincts. He knew the clock. You're talking about clock management. That kid's a freshman.
His 10th rebound of the half, 7 points to go with it. The star of the first half is Kevin Love of the UCLA Bruins. Not a pretty first half, a lot of turnovers, but the guy who might have played better than anybody else is Kevin Love.
Watch the instincts right here. He knows the clock situation. He knows he has to get it off quickly. I mean, that ball barely touched his hands. Unbelievable. He's so quick, he almost beat our great director. I mean, look at this right here. Top of the key, look at the clock up there. He definitely got it off. He definitely got it off.
Very smart and very skilled.
Savvy. Yep. Savvy. Instincts. Feel. Flow. Name it. He has it.
A good first half for Kevin Love, and UCLA needed it because not a lot else was going well for the number one team of the nation. But they go to the half with a 10-point lead on the Maryland Terrapins. They are checking to make sure the officials are that indeed the bucket should count. But it was clear that it was.
That's a new rule. That's a new rule. Another like they say, a new rule actually was incorporated a year or two ago, where they have to on a play at the end to make sure before they count it. But I'll tell you this, he beat that sound.
Yeah, clearly.
Absolutely, clearly. Clearly, one eye, I could see that.
And the officials have seen what you just saw. They're happy. It's a basket. And the first half comes to a close with UCLA leading Maryland 28-18 here in semifinal number one of the O'Reilly Auto Parts CBE Classic in Kansas City. Now it's time for the Dick's Sporting Good halftime report. Scottery's Tom Brennan, Doug Gottlieb.
All right, Dan, thanks so much. As you mentioned, a rather sloppy first half as both teams shooting south of the 35% mark. Scott Reese hanging out with the coach, Tom Brennan, and Doug Gottlieb. And the offense that they did see, coach, came from the inside.
It did, yes, indeed. And one of the bad things about these kind of games are they can get very ugly. You know, guys aren't really ready yet, and the teams aren't as sharp as they need to be. But James Gist is really playing well. Beautiful up and under move. He's had a couple of spectacular dunks, that being one of them. And he's only got 6 points, but he really did it spectacularly. There's no question
about
it.
You know, something to keep an eye on here is how UCLA handles the press. Because, again, playing without Darren Collison, and if they win, good chance. You know, Missouri wins tonight on ESPNU against Michigan State. UCLA will face a much better and much more tenacious full court, 40 minutes of hell from the Missouri Fighting Tigers. So be interesting to see how they adjust second half, preparing maybe for tomorrow night.
But it means we get more Russell Westbrook. You like the lid?
I like the flaming Mohawks, yeah, especially if you're going in and dunk on people. I like it.
The Matt Grothy School of Hair Design.
Yeah, works right for him.
Coming up on the Dick's Sporting Goods Halftime Report, we'll get you your earlier highlights from Maui. Plus, so the car is, in fact, pulling out of the station in Ann Arbor. We will have all the details.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Lowe's for all your home improvement needs. Lowe's, let's build something together. And Volvo, who believes that life is better lived together. Volvo for life.
What day is it?
Sir?
So I haven't missed it. Today, everyone gets a rear seat entertainment system. And to you, a rear seat entertainment system.
And one for you, and one for you, and one for you, young boy.
Rear seat entertainment system, everyone.
This holiday season, lease the all-new 2008 XC90 SUV and get a complimentary rear seat entertainment system.
PlayStation 3, starting at $399.
Introducing a world first. Braun Pulsonic. Powered by unique sonic pulses, over 10,000 microvibrations help expose and shave more hair with every stroke. For Braun's most thorough shave ever. The new Braun Pulsonic, powered by unique sonic pulses. Voted best electric shave ever. Braun Pulsonic. It's the perfect gift.
Man, you look beat.
Putting in the overtime.
Overtime? That triple overtime Texas game? Saw it. Insane. I also saw some NASCAR, college hoops, soccer. Dudes, I am Mr. Sports.
Take it easy, Chief. No need to prove your fanhood to us.
Really? All right, cool. Yeah, all right.
Watch more live sports online than ever before on ESPN360.com and be proud of your fanhood.
Welcome back to the Dick's Sporting Goods Halftime Report.
Well, you heard the coach singing his praises. James Gist, pretty on the up and under. He's got a half dozen, but the Terps down 10 at the break. Well, Michael Vick turned himself in early, surrendering to U.S. Marshals Monday. He will remain in jail until his sentencing on December the 10th. Vick anticipates a prison term on the federal dogfighting conspiracy charge. He could face up to 5 years in prison. For uplifting news, Alex Rodriguez will head back to the Yanks as American League MVP. No surprise, A-Rod receiving 26 first-place votes from the Baseball Writers Association. Maglio Ordóñez finished a distant second in the voting. Third MVP for A-Rod, by the way, second with New York. Other baseball news, the A's get John Garland from the White Sox in exchange for shortstop Orlando Cabrera and cash considerations. And the Yanks, busy day. They and the Red Sox retain players Mariano Rivera and Mike Lowell, respectively. It has been a tumultuous college football season in Ann Arbor, beginning with a loss to Appalachian State, ending with a loss to Ohio State, and somewhere in the middle, an 8-game win streak. Lloyd Carr, as expected, announced his retirement today, but rest assured, he was not forced out by the university. It was merely a question of timing.
Part of your responsibility is to know when you don't have everything that it takes. This is a tough job. It's the greatest of jobs, but it's a tough job. It's simply time for me and what I'm going to do. I have an opportunity to stay here, and which I appreciate, but I'm just going to see what's out there, and hopefully I can do something that will be meaningful.
ESPN.com's Joe Shad has introduced these four as potential replacements for Carr at Michigan. Of course, Les Miles, his return would be much ballyhooed as a Michigan alum. Kirk Ferentz done a nice job at Iowa. Brian Kelly, sensational at Cincinnati. And of course, we all know what Rich Rodriguez has done at West Virginia. Well, the Marquette Golden Eagles heading to the island with a whole lot of athletic ability, but they struggled a bit against the host team, Chaminade.
This halftime report is presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's.
Nike ACG, now at Dick's Sporting Goods.
Get the best sports and movies in HD free for 6 months. Plus, get a free HD DVR upgrade. Get over 70 national HD channels today, and more on the way with Dish Network.
What day is it?
Sir?
So I haven't missed it. Today, everyone gets a rear seat entertainment system. And to you, a rear seat entertainment system.
And one for you, and one for you, and one for you, young boy.
This holiday season, lease the all-new 2008 XC70 crossover and get a complimentary rear seat entertainment system.
Think of Mike Wallace and the Geico Chevrolet.
Whatever. He's out there selling current shirts. I'm out there to win.
Isn't he your cousin?
I didn't say I wouldn't go fishing with the man. All I'm saying is, he comes near me, I'll put him in the wall.
But you don't race in the Busch Series.
Listen, go-kart track, grocery store, those remote control boats. When it comes to Mike Wallace, story ends with me putting him in the wall.
Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
This halftime report is presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's.
EA Sports Maui Invitational, Marquette and Chaminade. This far from a blowout. Second half, Usman Barrow, the pilfer, give it up to Wesley Matthews. Nice finish, but that was his only field goal on the day. Golden Eagles up a dozen. Chaminade hanging tough. Roderick Johnson.
Coached by former Tommy Brennan assistant Matty Marr, I might add. He did a heck of a job right there until the end.
Oh, he's 26. He's mature.
I just ran out of gas.
Dominic James, the steal. Give it up to Jerome McNeil, who had a game-high 22. And Marquette does survive and advance in the Maui. Sean Sutton and Oklahoma State taking on LSU and Marcus Dove. You know about the defense, but they got to get some offense out of him this year.
Yeah, he had a tough summer with the DUI, but spent a lot of his time when he was suspended working in the gym on his offensive game, which was non-existent until this point in his career.
Second half of a six-point game, Terrell Harris rise and fire. Cowboys shooting 50% from beyond the arc, but LSU makes a late run. Chris Johnson. Three of his 19, all of a sudden, three-point game.
Got a 21-point lead to three. That's a great comeback by LSU, but they just did not have enough at the end.
Well, here it was. Garrett Temple straight away for the tie. Iron unkind. Rebound Harris. Cowboys hang on 83-77. This is tough. Louisville senior David Padgett could be out for this season. Broken right kneecap suffered in Sunday's win over Jackson State. The injury will take at least 10 weeks to heal. It may require surgery. Tough for a kid who's been riddled with injuries throughout his collegiate career. Meanwhile, a lot of good stuff to come here on the ESPN family of networks. Both games here on ESPN2. Princeton and Duke coming up at 9 Eastern. And Arizona State, the last Division I team to tip off its season tonight against the Illini, 11 Eastern. Those two meeting for the first time in more than three decades. Now you talk about the Duke Blue Devils, always, Tom, one of the more front and center teams in the nation. What's the X factor for Coach K's kids this year?
What I really believe the X factor would be is the fact that I think Paulus is going to come back, Greg Paulus, and have a great year. I thought he was injured last year. He got beaten a lot. But I think he's a tough kid. He's a former quarterback. I think he's really taking the challenge to be Duke's leader. And it's in my opinion that he's going to come back and have a great year for him.
Well, listen, I think he'll be better this year because he'll make better decisions. Remember, he doesn't even have a 2-1 assist-to-turnover ratio in either of his two seasons as a collegiate player, despite the fact that in his first year he had two first-round picks as his weapons. But I think there are enough weapons at Duke to the point where he'll probably be overshadowed. In fact, their best lineup may be with Greg Paulus not in the game. I mean, you can throw a lineup out there with Shire, with Taylor King, with Kyle Singler, and Nolan Smith, and DeMarcus Nelson, and you don't have to have, and even when he's out there, he doesn't have to break down a defense as Bobby Hurley, as Chris Duhon, and others have done in the past.
That's what a bad year he had. He said they could be better without him.
Yeah, right.
The first high school American, he's their point guard, their leader. I can't believe they could be better without him.
Well, they could be better without him, and the fact is they've brought in a bevy of talented wings. Now, they don't have great bigs, and by the way, a big that could be playing for Duke, Eric Boateng, just happens to be playing for Arizona State tonight.
The plot thickens, and those two could wind up meeting later round in the Maui. See that game at 11 Eastern, but we still got a half of basketball to be played in KC. Josh Shipp and the Bruins up 10 on Maryland. Back to Kansas City after this.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Lowe's. For all your home improvement needs, Lowe's. Let's build something together. And Volkswagen. When you get into a Volkswagen, it gets into you.
We're here today testing for the new Volkswagen Sign and Drive event, where you can get a new VW for practically just your signature. Just sign and drive. Introducing the Sign, Then Drive year-end event. Even better.
No down payment, no first month's payment, zero due at signing. Now until January 2nd.
You know what? You've earned this. Never flat from Spalding. True to the game.
Life is busy, but some people seem to get more done than others. Multitaskers. And when the Palm Central was designed, Sprint thought of these people. Then we gave it Sprint speed. You can email, text, chat, go online so fast.
People may wonder how many of you there really are.
Introducing the Palm Centro, only from Sprint, for just $99.99 on the fastest national mobile broadband network. Multitask at Sprint speed.
You
can't turn on the TV or pick up a newspaper without seeing something about America's healthcare crisis. Are you one of the 43 million uninsured? Well, good news. You're already approved for health insurance with us. This is not a discount card, and everyone's accepted no matter your health or pre-existing conditions up to age 64. And it's less than $160 a month for individuals or $240 a month for families. Join one of the largest and oldest PPO healthcare networks. Over 400,000 doctors, 52,000 clinics, 3,800 hospitals, and virtually every pharmacy. Thousands already enjoy excellent health care for less than $160 a month. This is not a discount card. Your insured benefits cover doctors, hospitals, surgery, maternity, diagnostics, pharmacy, accidents, and so much more. Don't risk waiting. Call now. There are no questions asked, no physical exam. Enroll quickly and easily for less than $160 a month. You must call now.
Welcome back to the Sprint Center in Kansas City, the first semifinal here with the O'Reilly Auto Parts CBE Classic, all a part of Feast Week presented by Lowe's. UCLA leading Maryland by 10. A ton of turnovers in the first half, and both teams shot only 33%.
Well, look at the turnovers, as you said, 30 turnovers, field goals, 2 for 10 from 3, 0 for 6. Really not a smooth game. Both clubs doing a pretty good job defensively. But when you think about 28-18 with the three-point shot, with a shot clock, really hard to comprehend.
Maryland's pressure certainly bothered UCLA at times, and Maryland could not take care of the basketball at the offensive end of the floor. Let's go to Doris Burke now with what adjustments Gary Williams feels his team needs to make. Doris?
Well, both teams pleased with their defense. For Gary Williams, he said it's about making shots. We shot 30% and we had wide open looks. UCLA feels like they dodged a bullet, giving up a lot of those open shots. Against this pressure, they want to avoid the corners and they want to do a better job in transition D.
Well, I'll tell you, Doris, there's no question they got to shoot the ball better. But UCLA, they'll tip in by Love. He starts at the high post. They do an effective job against the trap, because he's an excellent relay man. They bring him the ball, he looks opposite, and then he goes right down the gut and he tips it with his left hand. He's terrific, Dan. He's absolutely terrific.
And a travel. Yet another Maryland turnover. Now, Gary Williams knew that Kevin Love was going to be a handful coming into this game. And again, keep in mind how young the Maryland team is. They start three sophomores, and their first four players off the bench are all freshmen.
Oh, very young basketball team. They lost so much from last year. A team that won 25 games.
Ship. Good catch by Love, too, on a pass a little low, and again, he follows his own miss.
Nobody puts a body on him. Very strong. He squares his body exceptionally well. Timeout, the Terps. Not the kind of start you want when you're down 10, down 14 right now.
So number one, UCLA has extended their lead here early in the second half.
The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship coming in March.
A new O'Reilly Auto Parts store. That means better parts, better people, and better prices are just around the corner. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices.
Half-price drinks taste even better than regular-priced drinks.
I know.
You know?
I gotta say, I enjoy the concept of happy hour, but I feel like it's not accurate because it's from 2 to 4. It should be happy hours.
That just doesn't, that has no, like, pop to it, though.
A couple hours of drink fun.
Unsad, wet afternoon chunk.
Maybe happy hours.
I like that. Yeah, I like that.
That's better.
Happy hour at Sonic. Over 168,000 fountain drink and slush combinations, like our cherry limeade. Half price from 2 to 4 p.m. every day, because Sonic is your ultimate drink stop.
We're here today testing for the new Volkswagen Sign and Drive event, where you can get a new VW for practically just your signature. Just sign and drive.
Thank you.
Introducing the Sign Then Drive year-end event. Even better.
No down payment, no first month's payment, zero due at signing. Now until January 2nd.
It's the most traded market in the world, with over $3 trillion traded every day. It's open 24 hours a day, 5 days a week. It's the global foreign exchange market at Forex.com. Trade the euro, yen, U.S. dollar, and other currencies. Go to Forex.com today, set up a free practice account, and try currency trading risk-free. Then when you're ready, just click and trade. Forex.com, commission-free currency trading on your schedule, at your fingertips. Go to Forex.com today.
This ESPN2 telecast is available in stunning high definition on ESPN2 HD. Presented by Olivia, the CBE, the College Basketball Experience, housing the National Collegiate of Basketball Hall of Fame. Measure your wingspan.
Wow.
See how your hands measure up to Wilt. You can put your foot into a footprint of Shaquille O'Neal in there, which is which is a very strange thing to do. The Michigan State Spartans are in the house for the second semifinal tonight. Coming up tonight on ESPNU at 9:30 Eastern Time against the Missouri Tigers, who figure to have the majority of the crowd behind them, with Columbia being just 125 miles away.
They also have that style of play. They run, press, and shoot. Michael Anderson's club won 18 games last year, returned most players, and have a real star in Damari Carroll, a transfer from out of Vanderbilt.
And the coach's nephew.
Coach's nephew. That helps, I guess. Yeah, that helps.
Yep.
Gary will never, ever stop coaching. On every possession, you talk about a guy that has a passion and loves being in the arena, teaching, coaching. This guy's been doing it for years.
Eric Hayes, a very quiet night so far. Number five, Osby inside. Love holds his ground, and Osby banks one in.
They're going to get Osby some touches. Last game, he went to the free throw line 20 times. Mm-hmm. UCLA's done a great job keeping him away from the basketball.
A 6'8 senior from Richmond, Virginia, brings the deficit down to a dozen.
Love lays a big screen, then he rotates inside.
Here comes Shipp. He can shoot it. He can put it on the floor as well.
He's so explosive. He spotted a little opening in the defense, and he just exploded to the goal.
Hayes goes around his man. Left-handed layup. No basket.
Charge on the play.
Kevin Love.
Hey, little change of coaching staff for Gary Williams. Michael Adams had to step aside because of the fact of a little personal problem, and Joey Harrington came aboard. Remember that name? Hofstra head coach of Colorado. He told me he was doing real estate. Gary called him 11:30 at night and said, I need you. I want you to practice tomorrow at 3.
Wow. Oh. Alfred Aboya making some noise here at the Sprint Center.
You know, we're going to hear a lot about Love. You're going to hear a lot about Collison. But those guys, the complimentary players, when you're talking about guys like Aboya and Amada Real,
yep,
they are so important to this team.
Aboya does more, Ben Howland says, than his numbers would indicate. He made a lot of noise with that jam right there.
Introducing a world first. Braun Pulsonic. Powered by unique sonic pulses, over 10,000 microvibrations help expose and shave more hair with every stroke. For Braun's most thorough shave ever. The new Braun Pulsonic, powered by unique sonic pulses. Voted best electric shave ever. Braun Pulsonic. It's the perfect gift.
Well, Alfred Aboya very early in this game took a charge, forced a turnover. He does a lot of little things. A hard worker, an intense guy, and a huge dunk at the other end for the Bruins to up their lead to 16. Good double team on Gist. Osby. Osby again in the middle of four Bruin defenders draws the foul.
Great second effort by Osby right there to get that opportunity. Chuck Drizel, by the way, lefty's son on the coaching staff along with Keith Booth. Hey, Doris, what about Osby and his hobbies? Come on, tell us about him.
Well, I'm a bit envious. He is a collector of classic cars. He owns a 1960, 62, and 68 Cadillac DeVille. Can you imagine this guy with that hair driving around campus? His goal after basketball, guys, he wants to open a chop shop. He's a directed guy, hopes to play basketball at the next level. I think he should do that sort of reality show on TV because he's got a tremendous personality.
That'd be great. He restores one vintage car every offseason, still has time to work on his game.
We got another reality show going on. Greenie, Mike Greenberg's going to do a show called Duet. What am I going to find out? You're going to do what?
I think you should do a reality show.
Wow. They ever follow me around and show, it'd be unbelievable.
Because I have visited your reality from time to time off air, and it's worth a TV show.
And you got to put up with it for 20 weeks. 20 weeks.
14-point lead, UCLA. Maryland stays with the pressure. Now they back off.
See how they will use Love as a release guy, but Maryland backed off.
They got a big lineup in right now. Montreal and Love both in the game together. Mbamute is the small forward. Westbrook and Shipp in the backcourt. Driving Mbamute. Got a size advantage over Hayes, and he uses it.
I mean, there's another one of the guys we talked about. I talked earlier of Boya and certainly the Lorenzo Real as well, Montreal. But you got to throw in Luke Rashadi there as well.
Mbamute and Aboya both from Cameroon, and two mainstays on this UCLA team. A tough catch by Gist, and he is fouled.
You know, what we're seeing right now is certainly not going to be the real UCLA.
The Dick's Sporting Goods NIT season tip-off, all a part of Feast Week presented by Lowe's, is on ESPN2 Wednesday night with a doubleheader. Washington against Texas A&M at 7 Eastern, and then Syracuse at Ohio State at 9 Eastern. Dante Green, Johnny Flynn, two more of the great young freshman class. They have been in starring roles early for Jim Boeheim's Orange.
And also, as you look at Collison, what about you talking Ohio State? Thad Mata done a great job. Yep. He's got Costas Koufos. I mean, that's another heck of a player. So Koufos, Dante Green, New York City, the Big Apple, Madison Square Garden. They'll have turkey on Thanksgiving Day.
Hey, looking forward to the Big Ten ACC Challenge, which we'll have not that far away. We'll be in Columbus, Ohio State hosting North Carolina. There's a three from the wing for Shipp.
They're doing a great job against the pressure. They're bringing the ball up, getting it to open people.
Gist into traffic. Going right into the teeth of the defense. He paid the price, and Westbrook at the other end.
You know, Westbrook has quietly done a solid job. At the end of the half, look at a teammate. That's a teammate. Jumping, cheering. He had 5 assists, only 2 turnovers. Was steady.
And again, we've talked about it, but when Collison comes back, when Roll comes back, Ben Howland said, 2 of my top 6 are out right now. So think of how much stronger they'll be in Howland's eyes when those two guys come back.
And he's not just another player. When we talk about Collison, yeah, you can make a case for him being the best point guard in America. And we know how much and how important it is to have great point guard play. There's the athleticism, the leaping ability. I love kids that are in the game. Doing a little dance. He said, Coach, my knee feels a little better. Look at me dancing.
Yeah, looks pretty good right there.
Ben doesn't want to rush him back.
Well, Maryland keeps pressing. UCLA struggled with it at times in the first half, Dick, but it looks like they have found a way to beat it here in the second half.
Yeah, they're doing a great job now against the trap, moving the basketball, not trying to dribble through it. We'll take a look at the trap right here. See Maryland trying to go to full court. Step up to the basketball. You got to meet. See right here? Look, he's got 3 guys. He's ready to go up the sideline. Do a super jump. See right up the sideline. And they got to freeze it. And then you touch here, running right to the 3-point line. He could also have this option and 2 options. He's going to find the open man to the wing. Thank you. We'll go for the trifecta.
Well, and Love is such a weapon because whether he's 6'8 and 3/4, however tall he is exactly, he can see over most defenders who are up there pressing him, and he can make a good pass.
You know, we mentioned the injuries for UCLA. David Neal, a very important player to Maryland, is on the sideline as well with a shoulder injury.
Had surgery, aggravated it. He's going to be out about 3 weeks. Feast Week presented by Lowe's continues from Maui. It's the EA Sports Maui Invitational. Marquette, which beat Chaminade tonight, will take on Oklahoma State, which beat LSU tonight. And then in the second game tomorrow night at 9 Eastern, the winner of Princeton and Duke against the winner of Arizona State and Illinois.
You know, out of the gate right now, I mean, it's early before you can make a real true assessment. I think the Pac-10 is going to be the toughest conference in America. And I think the Big East is right there with them. I think they're 1-2 in terms of depth. They get so many outstanding clubs.
Well, preseason, the Pac-10 had 7 teams ranked in the top 25.
You know, Weaver and Lowe at Washington State with Tony Bennett on the sideline. I'm going to see the real Tony Bennett though Friday night sing in Vegas.
Tony Bennett, the National Coach of the Year last year, as Osby sneaks inside.
I like his ability in that post. I just think he needs more touches.
And you know what? With Ben Howland coming to the Pac-10 and now with Washington State getting back to prominence, the league has taken on a bit of a different look. It's not just to get up and down, try to outscore your opponent. There's more physicality. There's more defense in the league.
Well, you know, Ernie Kent's got a good club down there as well. Four starters back from last year's team.
Adrian Bowie, the freshman from Greenbelt, Maryland, leads them down the floor. Milbourne's jumper settles in.
See, they need guys like Milbourne. They got to find some people on the bench, Tucker, and people like Dupree to give them some quality minutes. They can't just rely on Vasquez and Gist and Osby.
Maryland, by the way, preseason picked sixth in the ACC. North Carolina, the runaway top pick. Duke was second. NC State third. Clemson fourth. Virginia fifth.
I'm going to tell you the team to really watch in the ACC. They got a great win over on the Clemson Tigers. I believe they're for real. I think that club is for real. But UCLA is for real. Give us a little dance, Darren. Give us a little dance.
Saying used to dominate this game.
Hey, Mike, you got my shirt on again, man.
No, not this one, Chris. I've had it forever.
Gift for my grandma.
Your grandma?
Yeah, Cora. Grandma Cora.
It's got my number on it, man.
You know what, Chris? I'm not going to sit here and have you disrespect Grandma Cora.
Mike.
ESPN, your NBA destination for games Wednesdays and Fridays, plus in-depth analysis all week.
That means better parts, better people, and better prices are just around the corner. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices.
We're here today testing for the new Volkswagen Sign and Drive event, where you can get a new VW for practically just your signature. Just sign and drive. Introducing the Sign, Then Drive year-end event. Even better.
No down payment, no first month's payment, zero due at signing. Now until January 2nd.
Rated T for teen.
Back here in Kansas City again, the 2007 induction class put into the National Collegiate Basketball Hall of Fame last night. These are five of the members from left to right: Dick Barnett, Dick Groh, Lefty Driesell, Vic Bubas, and Norm Stewart, the longtime coach at Missouri, 32 years in Columbia, better than 700 wins in his career. Part of the class inducted into the Collegiate Basketball Hall of Fame, along with Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Austin Carr, the great from Notre Dame, and Guy Lewis, the longtime coach at Houston. I know one of our favorite guys, one of our favorite stories, is Dick Groh. It's tough to believe some of the things that he accomplished. While at Duke, he led the nation as a senior in scoring
and assists
in the same year. Went on to play in the NBA, but, oh, by the way, played Major League Baseball and won the MVP with the Pittsburgh Pirates in 1960.
A batting champ. As I said when I did the opening, I said, Dick, you broke my heart. I was a big Yankee fan in 1960. You broke my heart. But can you imagine how good he was? Scored over 800 points without the three-point shot and without the one-on-one.
Still works as a broadcaster, as the analyst for the University of Pittsburgh with Bill Hillgrove, a terrific duo up there in Pittsburgh, who, by the way, we'll see against Duke at the Garden in December. But Dick Groh, one of the great guys, a terrific class. And again, the National Collegiate Basketball Hall of Fame complimenting the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame, and it's primarily for people like Groh, who did not warrant inclusion in the Naismith Hall of Fame, but for their collegiate accomplishments, something like the Collegiate Basketball Hall of Fame was created.
Well, same with Guy V. Lewis. I mean, five times, went to the Final Four, developed Hall of Famers like Elvin Hayes and certainly Hakeem Olajuwon, and you think about Clyde Drexler as a look at Dick Groh, MVP, two World Series championships. But you know what was really interesting? He said, let me tell you, I played 16 years in the major leagues, as he told the crowd, but I have to admit this, my first love and always my number one love has been college basketball. Did he say that last night?
Yep.
Unbelievable.
A terrific guy. Yep. Maryland staying with the pressure, trying to cut into this deficit and gradually working it down to a more manageable number, and another UCLA turnover.
You know why? Because Mr. Love is sitting on the sideline and nobody flashed to the basketball. You got to flash a post up. They had nobody as a relay man. That's the reason why. See, right here. You're not supposed to drink water. Come on, get out there and play. Get out there and play. You might only be there for 1 year, so play every minute.
Montreal in for Love in the middle. And Gist is held by Aboya. It's a pretty good matchup right there.
I know I'm selfish, but would you imagine if he stayed in school and joined those four recruits coming in? They're going to be dancing with joy. What a beautiful campus down in Westwood. It is gorgeous. I mean, I absolutely love it. I go down there, and I can't wait to go over Nate and Al's, go to the deli, see Larry King there,
well,
having his breakfast.
We're going to take you down there. We got a game day game
there. I know,
there.
Arizona.
Yeah, on February the 2nd.
Can't wait to go.
A Saturday prime game. Looking forward to that. Ben Hallett, of course, grew up in Southern California, grew up a UCLA fan. He describes this as his dream job to be the head coach of the Bruins.
Well, you know what? I think a lot of people would say UCLA would be a dream job. You know, think about it. North Carolina, UCLA, Kentucky's. I mean, those are incredible places. Duke.
It comes with pressure. It comes with expectations. Ben Hallett in Northern Arizona took his team the first year they struggled. They got better and better, went to Pittsburgh. Again, they struggled at the outset, rebuilt the program. They got better and better, went to the Sweet 16 a couple of times, and now Final Four appearances each of the last 2 years at UCLA.
Well, you know, you think about Ben Hallett. I'm sure his eyes lit up when that job was open and he became the number one guy they wanted. I think the same thing's going to probably happen up in Michigan in football with the coach of LSU,
right.
Miles, who's a Michigan graduate whose wife went to the University of Michigan, who worked and played for Bo Schembechler. I think ultimately that's going to happen, and I feel very bad for Lloyd Carr. Carr, five Big Ten championships, national championship, but never good enough. Standards get so high, it's unbelievable. We wish him the best in whatever he does.
Dupree turns it over. If Maryland could hang on to the basketball, they might have a chance to be in this game here tonight, and it's driving Gary Williams up the wall.
Yeah, but you know what? The reason they're not handling the basketball is the effectiveness of the defense of UCLA. That's the one thing that Ben Hallett brought there. Special defense. And that's why Memphis is so good.
Yeah.
Memphis will defend every night. They may have a slump shooting the basketball, but defensively, they will be in your face every night.
Love finds Shipp. 10 on the shot clock. Shipp finds Montreal inside for the easy layup.
I can't emphasize enough for the UCLA followers how important those kids are. Montreal, Aboya, Luke Richard, Umeya Mute. You like the way I said that, huh?
I like the way you say you know that. We're going to be working on that all season long. We'll see them a few times this year. And he is a special player. Stolen by Westbrook. Ahead to Shipp, and a block is the call. Well, you talked about football a little bit in Michigan. There is some kind of football game coming up just down the street from us this weekend. Saturday night, 8 Eastern on ABC. The biggest game in the history of the long rivalry between Kansas and Missouri. The winner will win the Big 12 North, play in the Big 12 championship, and if they win that, certainly enhance their opportunity to play, at least play and perhaps win
the national championship. Now, who would have ever believed? There's a Jayhawk. Oh, we found a Jayhawk. There's a Jayhawk. Rock Chalk Jayhawk. See, Bill Self made sure. Look at Lou Perkins. You think he's strutting? He's sitting there with Tom O'Connor, chairman. He's not dumb. He's sitting with the chairman to his left of the committee, selection committee, and he's nodding his head. Lou has done a phenomenal job. He hung with his football coach, when a lot of people may not have. He hung with Mark Mangino, and now they're 11-0.
I know you've talked a lot over the years about schools that combine great basketball and great football programs. Kansas has never warranted getting mentioned in that conversation until this year.
You know, the two quarterbacks to me aren't getting enough national publicity. Daniel and Reising. They have done such phenomenal jobs. It's unbelievable. Larry Keating sitting right next to Tom O'Connor. Larry, former. He was a former AD at Seton Hall, now associate AD at Kansas.
They're playing that football game, by the way, at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. They're not playing it on campus at KU.
Larry Sun, by the way, used to be an assistant at UCLA, Carey, and now the coach of Santa Clara.
And now some kind of a conversation between one of the officials and Ben Howland. The official thought that Dwayne Gladden thought that Ben Howland wanted a timeout, heard something that wasn't said evidently, so he blew his whistle. So now UCLA will inbound it.
Scoring points is going to be really, I think, a dilemma for Maryland all year. Putting a lot of points on a board. They're limited offensively in terms of the weapons that they have.
Gist and Vasquez, the two best. Westbrook's jumper not there.
I feel so bad for Gary because I know how hard he coaches and pours his heart into it. And is certainly, to me, a future Hall of Famer.
Gist, a little bit strong in the three. And Mbamute with a rebound.
You can't win without players like Mbamute. You can't win without guys like that. You
blue
need
collar
those
guys.
Blue collar guys, warriors, winners, very physical.
Our second game will have Missouri and Michigan State. And Michigan State is led generally by perimeter players, but they've got a whole slew. There's a beautiful block by Osby. Michigan State with a bunch of blue collar big guys. Well, rebound, set screens, block shots.
Well, they've been beating their opponents on the glass this year to the tune of about 25 rebounds per game.
46-29 Bruins, despite a great effort by Bombali Osby. A big block by the Terp. And a big dunk at the Hall of Fame right next door. They've got 7-foot rims. Even we could dunk.
Wow, look at that. I want to go dunk.
Not on the abdomen, Cameron.
Hi.
This is Matthews. I'm Steve, your Progressive Claims rep.
All right.
I inspected the damage on your car, and you're all set.
Oh, thanks so much for coming by. My insurance agent recommended Progressive because you do this kind of stuff for free. I have four boys, so the smallest errand is...
It's no problem. Yeah.
Okay, thanks so much. Bye.
With Progressive, saving hundreds is just the beginning. Contact a local independent agent to switch today.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I need you to step back.
Probably my rent.
Cell phone, jewelry, or...
Another ring.
Okay. Anything in your pocket, or...
Oh, 2003. I always forget about that one.
Ben Stone never thought he'd get a girl.
She looks smart.
Like Allison.
You're prettier than I am.
But his biggest surprise is yet to come.
I'm pregnant.
With a baby?
Yes.
Then what are you hitting on me for?
How did this happen?
From the director of The 40-Year-Old Virgin.
What do you think of him? He's funny, right?
Fetch. All right, bring him back.
He's playing fetch with my kids.
Knocked Up.
He's treating my kids like their dogs.
Go get it. Fetch.
Hockey's newest stars are busting the game wide open. NHL Center Ice on DirecTV. Follow your favorite team no matter where you live. Get up to 40 games a week from around the league, plus select games in crystal clear HD. Just four payments of $42.25. Break away now. Order NHL Center Ice and never miss a moment. Visit DirecTV.com or call 1-800-GET-SPORTS today.
UCLA up 17 on Maryland, and yes, as of today, a new poll coming out, a new coaches poll coming out. UCLA is now number one, but so is North Carolina. North Carolina lost some votes after Davidson played them so tough. So we've got co-number ones right now. Memphis 3, Kansas 4, Georgetown 5. Louisville got some bad news. David Padgett, a knee injury, will likely be gone for the season. Tennessee, Indiana, Washington State, and Duke rounding out the top 10. Duke and Princeton next year on ESPN2 for Maui.
And take a look at Duke right now, Kyle Singler. Hey, how do you think they feel at Oregon? Losing Singler and losing Love.
Yep.
Imagine if those two guys decided to join the Ducks with the four players they're returning. Brian Taylor's son, Bryce Taylor. You don't remember Brian Taylor, but I do. Played in Perth Amboy, New Jersey. Went to Princeton. Played in the ABA. It's his son, Bryce, who's a terrific player.
I'm sure the reception will not be so good for Kevin Love when UCLA goes up to Oregon this season. But just like, you know, Sean May discovered when North Carolina went back to Bloomington in that game we did a couple of years ago.
Well, you got to go where your heart is and where you want to be. And he wanted to be at UCLA Bruin.
Well, why is UCLA winning this game? Look at some of the
hustle stats,
rebounds, and they've taken some charges, points off, turnovers. Neither team has really executed all that well, to be honest with you. It's just Maryland's been worse than UCLA. Vasquez with a nice jumper.
I like Vasquez. I know he's really struggling a little bit right here, but he's a solid player, plays with a lot of jubilation, has a good feel for the game, loves playing, loves competing.
Three-guard look right now for the Terps. Bowie has joined Hayes and Vasquez out there along with Gist and Osby.
Trying to get a little more speed on the floor. You know, Westbrook's done a solid job, yep, man. He really has. He's not special in terms of making shots or trying to be spectacular, but he's been very solid.
Trying to get them into their offense, not rushing things. Now he's got to rush with a shot clock at 4.
Look at the high screen. Nobody communicated for Vasquez.
Good if it goes. Westbrook with a rebound. Montreal with a rebound. Montreal again. And finally, it's Maryland basketball, despite the great effort on the glass by the Bruins. Bowie, nice pass.
Nice pass.
Vasquez.
Nice pass. Look at the emotion. I love the kid from Venezuela. Plays with emotion like his coach. Look at his coach. I don't think there's any doubt that one day we'll be here and Gary Williams will be introduced.
Agreed.
And inducted.
Agreed.
Into the Hall of Fame at a collegiate level.
A quick 6-0 run for Maryland to bring him back within 11. Well, let's talk about Gravis Vasquez and what he brings to the Terps, Dick.
Well, take a look at Vasquez. Look at him running the floor, catching him. Look at the emotion. Look at the emotion. Really, very emotional. Look at him screen. See the down screen? Comes off the curl move. Nails it. He'd be one of the better guards in the ACC.
Just a sophomore.
Keep an eye on Clemson this year. Oliver Purnell's club is going to be legitimate. I know last year they disappointed after going 17 and zip. I also was impressed with Connecticut. I'll tell you what.
Yeah, they're better.
They're much better.
Yep.
A.J. Price certainly and Robinson make them a lot better.
Maryland back within 11 of the number one team in the nation, of one of the number one teams in the nation, the UCLA Bruins.
So here goes this 1-2. Up front they do like a 1-2 trap.
And it worked again. The focal point in shoot-around today was make one of the big guys be the guy to dribble the ball over the timeline and then trap him as soon as he gets into the front court, and it's worked beautifully.
Well, you know, Maryland's taken away the relay pass side to side. You got to go north-south against the pressure there.
Vasquez, everything but the finish. Rebound, Dragovic.
They're going side to side, laterally going east-west. Going to go north-south.
And they didn't involve Love the last time they tried to bring the ball up. They used Dragovic, and he was the guy who threw it away. Pressure on Ship, and he will drive and draw the foul.
So you know the one thing, Gary Williams' kids are never going to roll over. Never going to roll over. He will not tolerate it. See, right here now, look, somebody's got to flash to the open area. And I went, freeze it right here, freeze it. Here's the trap. So you got a trap and a trap here. Somebody's got to flash here. You got to get the ball to the middle, not lateral.
It looked like Love was getting into position, but Dragovic elected to pass across the court.
Nice tip. Ooh.
Love, another rebound. A good effort on that possession by the Terps, but to no avail.
See, right now, they got to involve Love a little bit more. He's going to get some touches. He's such an outstanding passer.
Yeah, we haven't really seen his ability to pass out of either the low post or the high post tonight.
Watch him in the pregame, you can see him pass the ball.
Osby with another block. He is controlling things defensively now.
Maryland can make a little run right here.
Bowie, and it's out of bounds. Off him, back to UCLA.
To me, Maryland is lacking one player. They need one more guy. As Osby coming over with the block.
That's a big-time block.
Yes, sir.
Because Aboya was going right to the rim. And Maryland has used another timeout. Still better than 9 minutes to play. They're down to one, trailing by 11, as we tell you about the Dick's Sporting Goods NIT season tip-off. All a part of Feast Week, presented by Lowe's. It's here on ESPN2 Wednesday night with a doubleheader. Washington taking on Texas A&M, post Billy Gillespie, post AC Law and so forth, but still a very strong team. And then Syracuse and Ohio State at 9 Eastern, right here on ESPN2.
You know, you talk about Texas A&M, DeAndre Jordan, the diaper dandy, yeah, seven-footer. He's made 13 consecutive shots, but he struggles on the free throw line. Mark Turgeon working with him. There's five dandies I like. I mean, Beasley, he's only averaging 30 and 20. Gordon, he's good for 30. Love, Mayo, and Rose. Mayo had 29 on the road against South Carolina in a big win.
Love, nice bounce pass. And a foul.
You know, he could have actually shot that ball. Could have went right down the lane. Very unselfish, but the lane was wide open.
Aboya is still down.
I'm going to tell you who would love and admire Kevin Love. John Wooden. He is so the typical John Wooden kind of boy. Look at this right here. I mean, he could have went right down the lane. He pulled up that dribble light foot a little too soon. It's unselfish. It's all about the team. See, that's what impressed me last night, listening to Bill Walton talking about Kareem. About Kareem was all about the ultimate end, the championship.
Well, you saw there was some tape hanging from the right wrist of Kevin Love that has since been taken off. Earlier in the game, he had two fingers taped together on his left hand. He suffered a small chipped bone at the base of his left index finger in practice a few days ago, and he began the game with that on his left hand, his non-shooting hand, but he has since taken it off.
He should go see my son-in-law as a hand surgeon. He should go see Dr. Chris Forzo. Hey, Chris, I'll give you some business. Come on up to UCLA.
12-point lead for the Bruins. Maryland has done a nice job defensively, forcing turnovers, getting some baskets. But as you said, Dick, it's awfully tough for them to score.
Yeah, well, offensively, the rhythm is really tough to have, especially against this good defensive club.
Milbourne, a one-handed rebound, and he lays it back up and in.
He's a guy that can elevate his game and give him that extra player.
This is as close as they've been in a while. Love, touch pass. Open for three.
See, he did not waste any time. He knew where his teammate was, open for the three. As soon as he caught the ball was out of his hands. I mean, you can't teach those things.
The Love assist makes it a 13-point game. Milbourne again.
Well, this might help the confidence of Milbourne. Gary was saying how they got to get him to really be productive, to join the like of Vasquez and Gisden, certainly Osby.
And Milbourne, if you're wondering, is left-handed. He scored the last two goals with his left hand, which is why he's looked so good doing it. And Osby fouls Love. For Osby, that's going to be his fourth. They need to keep him in the game if they've got any chance of mounting a comeback. It's 50-39 UCLA.
Incredible. No sore losers. No sore losers. No sore losers.
There's a new O'Reilly Auto Parts store. That means better parts, better people, and better prices are just around the corner. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices.
Life is busy, but some people seem to get more done than others. Multitaskers. They found a way to do several things all at once. And when the Palm Central was designed, Sprint thought of these people. Then we gave it Sprint speed. You can email, text, chat, go online so fast.
People may wonder how many of you there really are.
Introducing the Palm Centro, only from Sprint, on the fastest national mobile broadband network.
An ode to the Subway feast. Turkey, salami, cheese with roast beef, pepperoni and ham. Write this down, Chief. We got them all on freshly baked bread. The Subway feast. It's as big as my head. Subway, eat fresh.
Hearty taste, naturally nutritious. Planters, instinctively good.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts at better prices every day. And Sprint. The O'Reilly Auto Parts CBE Classic is rated for sprint speed. Sprint.
Back in Kansas City, adjacent to the College Basketball Experience, which houses the National Collegiate of Basketball Hall of Fame, full of UCLA inductees and exhibits, a 50-39 lead for the Bruins. And Kevin Love is having a terrific all-round game tonight.
Well, he does a great job. He has a great feel. Look at him. Ball over his head. looks, got good vision. Now watch this play. He catches the ball. He'll catch the ball, he releases it, and he knows where his shooter is. Westbrook wide open, and there's the three. But that was all created. Kevin Love was the guy that handled the ball against the pressure.
Has had a double-double for a while. 12 points, 14 rebounds, has a couple of assists as well. The passing ability is really the first thing you heard about Love when his name started getting out there and people started hearing about his talents. Passing was before anything else.
Well, he's a great outlet passer, too. He really does. He outlets really well. The best I've ever seen with the outlet was Wes Unseld, and he played years and years ago at Louisville. Louisville got a tough break, finding out David Paget will be done for the year.
We want to hear something interesting about Kevin Love. You know what his middle name is? Blocked there by Mbamute. His middle name is Wesley. His middle name is Wesley. Wes Unseld played with his dad on the Baltimore Bullets, and Kevin Love's middle name is named for Wes Unseld. So there you go.
There's the outlet. Maybe Wes worked with him.
Mbamute had the block at one end, left the jumper short. Milbourne might have gotten a finger on it. Now we've got a Maryland foul.
Love goes to the free throw line. He's having a solid, nothing spectacular, but just solid.
Osby had to come out of the game prior to that last timeout. He had committed his fourth foul, but he's getting ready to check back in. Gary Williams has no choice but to roll the dice right now.
I'll tell you, Dan, this might be the deepest year in terms of freshmen who are really influential players right away. I mean, it's unbelievable. Every day you pick up the paper, you read about another diaper dandy. I can't get over the stats of Michael Beasley. I mean, 30 and 20.
Well, we've talked a lot about the freshman here, Kevin Love. Let's go to Doris Burke, standing by with his dad. Doris?
Yeah, Stan, a very proud father. And I guess, Mr. Love, the first question, because you were a standout at Oregon, he grew up playing high school basketball in Oregon. How did he come to the choice for UCLA?
Well, Kevin was born in Santa Monica, California, and he has a lot of family down there. And then, of course, Ben Hallen and the chemistry with the team. He clicked with the guys, and so he chose UCLA. This is a terrific school.
He's an impressive young man. He seems mature beyond his years. Tell us from your perspective, what is his best attribute?
Well, I like his rebounding. You know, his rebounding is good. I like his scoring down low is great. He can pass well. But to me, as a dad, he's a good citizen.
There was a moment in his AAU career where I guess he took a pretty good shot to the face. Can you describe that and what you learned from that event?
Well, I tried to get him to wear a mouth guard, but he won't do it. He's got hammered pretty good in this game tonight. He's just you know, he learns from every game. That's what, he's a quick learner, and I'm sure he learns from every game.
Thank you so much for
joining us.
Thank you. Guys?
You know, Doris asked him what he likes the best. He liked his passing. He liked his toughness. He liked his scoring down low. He liked his citizenship. Yeah. I mean, a typical dad. He loves his son, baby, in every way possible.
He's got 16 rebounds. Got to love that tonight. As a Boya who set a big-time screen on Vasquez in that possession, eventually wound up with the basketball and got fouled. And again, Love with a nose for the basketball, comes up with a rebound. He's going to clear some space with those shoulders, isn't he?
And notice how he keeps the ball up above.
Yep.
Ready to make that outlet pass.
Well, Maryland got it down to 10 a couple of times here in the second half, but no closer than that.
Well, back-to-back seasons, winning 30 games for UCLA, first time since 72 and 73. And Hollins brought back that sense of pride to that jersey, those four letters, that pride is back at Pauley Pavilion.
Osby with a bucket to make it a 13-point game. Duke and Princeton from Maui next here on ESPN2. The tip just about 15 minutes away.
Well, if people like the performance of Love, they're going to like the performance of Kyle Singler. He's another youngster from out of Oregon. The two of them were such sensational scholastic players.
Duke bringing John Shire off the bench in the early going this year. Still getting his minutes, but coming off the bench.
How many times have a great breakout sophomore year? Gerald Henderson. Just like Earl Clark is down in Louisville as well.
Well, I know Henderson's one of the guys that you're focusing on as a sophomore, not getting a lot of attention. We're going to see one of the great sophomores in the country, it looks like, in the early going.
Raymar Morgan.
In our next game. That's right. Raymar Morgan of Michigan State over on ESPNU is off to a monster start for the Spartans, especially on the glass.
You know, he's another kid that doesn't get a lot of publicity as a South, but I think he'll have a breakout year.
Pretty nice play there by Luke Richard and Mbamute.
Looks like he's improved his jump shot.
Yep.
They say he's really worked on it. shot hundreds and hundreds of jumpers.
If they get healthy and stay healthy,
they're going to be dynamite. I don't think there's any doubt about it.
They got a lot going for them.
It's pretty nice when you can go to your club and you got Collison waiting, Michael Roll waiting, Keith. There's some super Souths, guys that need some ink. These aren't the guys like, for example, Ty Lawson and Ellington. These guys are going to be great breakout players this year. Spates, Clark, Morgan, Henderson, and Daniel Hackett had a triple-double. What a matchup that's going to be in Tinseltown when UCLA and Southern Cal go on with O.J. Mayo and Hackett. Tim Floyd's brought about excitement there. I know they lost their first game to Mercer, but they went on the road. They had Hackett back in the lineup. What a classy kid this is, too.
Now Collison out for UCLA with Padgett out for Louisville. It looks like for the season, Earl Clark is going to have to step up large for the Cardinals this year.
Palacios is out as well.
Yeah.
They hope to get him back in a couple of weeks.
Seems like Rick Pitino's teams are always battling a couple of major injuries. Ship the miss. Osby the rebound. And here come the Terps. Vasquez, Love got his arm in the way. Osby banks it home.
Osby's made some nice plays inside.
Got a dozen points now.
That's down to 11. Still got time on that clock. If they can find somebody to knock down a three.
Love fills the middle, takes the pass, and is fouled by Gist.
Made the right play going to the goal.
And is he a little shaken up? He's going for a walk way off the floor over near his coach, Ben Howland. And
he's going to get to that free throw line, though. There's the catch. Go right down the goal.
Number four on Gist.
Gist has been quiet. You know, he's an explosive player, great leaper, but he's been quiet here in the second half. So has Hayes. They've got no point production out of Hayes at all.
Love toweling off a little bit. Now we'll head to the free throw line.
Has good touch for a big guy. 6'8 and three quarters. I'll tell you, get the tape measure out. 6'8 and three quarters.
You can just see that from here to there, huh?
Yes, sir. Doesn't matter. Plays like he's 7 feet.
Bowie and Tucker back into the game. Well, comes by his size and his skill, honestly. As you saw Doris interviewing his dad, Stan, a terrific collegian at Oregon and played 4 years in the NBA. And looking up proudly, enjoying this game, seeing himself up on the big scoreboard here.
Certainly has to be happy of his effort.
The winner of this game will play the winner of Missouri and Michigan State our next game tomorrow night, 10 o'clock Eastern time here on ESPN2.
You know what UCLA makes you do? They make you make a number of passes. They really do.
Vasquez made a nice one to Osby, who's upset with himself that he couldn't finish.
Oh, Vasquez got great vision. He has great instincts, feel. Taps the basket. Knows where people are on the floor. Has good vision. He can find the open guy. UCLA's been to 17 Final Fours. The question is, will they put up the 12th banner?
Aboya called for the foul, and he's going to be done for the night. That is number five on him, so he will leave, and Amado Real will come back in for the Bruins.
You know, Ben was telling me before the game, with all the injuries, he's really got like 8 scholarship players.
Yeah. They haven't been able to practice the way they would like because of the injuries. 3 of their top 10 guys are out right now.
Well, they got some games coming up with Texas. Davidson, that'll be interesting. They're at Michigan. Michigan doesn't seem to have the personnel right now to challenge the big, big clubs, but John Beilein will get it done eventually. Yep. Manny Harris is going to be special for them.
Yep. John Beilein has won everywhere he's gone.
Got 10 ex-Bruins on NBA opening day rosters, including last year's guy Aaron Aflalo, now on a Detroit Pistons roster. Jordan Farmer playing a lot more, too, at UCLA.
Playing well.
Playing a lot more with the Lakers.
Playing well. 1 of 2 for Osby to make it an 11-point game as we near the 4-minute mark. Osby hollering something at Gist as they take their positions defensively. Osby gambles for the steal, commits the foul, and he doesn't like it. He's begging. He's begging.
He's begging. He's on his knees.
Because that's number five.
No, no, no.
Number five on Osby. I'll give the young man an A for effort tonight.
Yeah, he really played hard inside. Didn't get a lot of touches. When he did, he converted. He scored. They're going to find a way to get him the ball a little bit more.
Under 4 to go. Osby is out, and UCLA's up 11.
knows, there's a new O'Reilly Auto Parts store. That means better parts, better people, and better prices are just around the corner. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices.
Think back to when you were a child. What did you dream of as you fell asleep? Space travel? Or maybe you dreamed of a magic screen you could carry in your pocket. A screen that held your favorite music, pictures, and stories. And that brought all of this to you at the speed of light. That was your dream. And with the magic of Sprint Speed, it all came true.
It's so great that Sonic has this happy hour.
It's really
half
good.
Price drinks, you know?
Mm-hmm. It's so true, man.
I'm glad you told me about it. Yeah, why are you drinking? You get the straw in your mouth there while you're talking there.
We only have 2 hours, man. I want to maximize my drinking time.
Yeah, but when you talk, you can take the straw out of your mouth.
You're taking away from me. That's precious lost time.
Happy hour at Sonic. Over 168,000 fountain drink and slush combinations, like our cherry limeade. Half price from 2 to 4 p.m. every day, because Sonic is your ultimate drink stop.
There's a new O'Reilly Auto Parts store. That means better parts, better people, and better prices are just around the corner. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices.
Scott Reese in the studio. A lot of great basketball still to come. You know, the Duke Blue Devils, huge following even on the island of Maui. Greg Paulus and company taking on Princeton. They'll tip it off just about 8 minutes from now. And how about this? Another early season upset as Belmont goes into Tuscaloosa. And Justin Hare, the dagger with 2 seconds left. Bruins beat Alabama 85-83. Guys?
Wow, wow. Did I just hear Belmont beat Alabama at Alabama?
They beat Cincinnati at Cincinnati. The Atlantic Sun is having some kind of a start this year.
Hey, what about last night? You got, for example, Winthrop. They win. They beat Georgia Tech.
It will be. They just need Chad Henne and his experience in this rivalry game to try to lead them back and make this game competitive. And it's just not meant to be at this point for Henne and the Wolverines.
Mark Ortman is now taking a crack at Golston, and they've moved him in at right tackle.
Good luck.
And he comes inside and gets picked up by the back. And Manningham lets another one. That's the third drop pass by number 86 today. And the boos come down.
Manningham has had just a rough day trying to hold on to the football. That shot showed you it's not just that the ball is slick. His eyes are going up. He's looking at who's closing in on him before he holds on to the football. We've seen Manningham do that, and we've seen Arrington do that. And it's not like the Michigan wide receivers to get intimidated the way these guys have played so far in this game.
Hit on the release, and it is 4th and 10.
But what happens is when you have one individual that's become dominant up front like Golston, the offensive line starts to think so much about Golston that it frees up other defensive linemen to be able to make plays. And that time it's Larimore who fights in and beats one-on-one opportunity to get after Chad Henne. And they're going to go for it here on 4th down.
Yeah, 3:51 and you're down 14-3.
This is ball game right here.
It's been hard converting 3rd and 2, leave alone 4th and 10. Going downfield, Manningham. No flag. Ohio State takes over. 3:44 to go. That's all that separates the Buckeyes from the Rose Bowl in Pasadena.
What a difference 1 week makes for an Ohio State defense. Last week against the Illini, they played back. They didn't play with much confidence and much swagger. This week, Jim Haycock and Luke Fickell decided to turn this defense loose. And we're almost to the end of the game. And Michigan right now has 91 yards of total offense.
Jim Trussell will go to work on the play clock. I should say that game clock, meant to say. And I was looking at the play clock myself that time. Beatty Wells, of course, the player of the game as far as Ohio State is concerned.
It needs to be noted, a lot of talk about Mike Hart and Michigan and these seniors trying to win this game. But Jim Trussell, you think about this, what he's had, the success against this Michigan team, but it's a team with two seniors on it, one on offense and one on defense.
We'll take a break.
This is real life couple Beth and Mark, who were matched on eHarmony.com.
It seemed to me that all the other sites was pretty much just the same as like going trolling at the bar, except you were in your own house.
Why did they choose eHarmony after trying other sites?
That was the one site that people were very serious about finding their mate. She was pretty and beautiful smile and everything I was looking for.
Discover what Beth and Mark found. Log on today and review your matches for free.
Life in layers. Nike ACG, now at Dick's Sporting Goods.
ESPNU brings you college sports 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The passion, the anticipation, the excitement.
Wide open, touchdown!
Every season.
This is for three, count it!
Every reason to watch.
That's gonna do it!
Every sport, all year round. Tonight, at 7:45, the CBE Classic third place game. Maryland takes on Missouri. Then at 10, Feast Week Basketball. Number 11, Oregon battles St. Mary's. ESPNU, always in season. Friday afternoon football on ESPNU. At 11 a.m., the Central Michigan Chippewas storm into Akron to take on the Zips. Then at 2:30, a battle in Ohio as the Toledo Rockets visit Bowling Green.
Friday afternoon football starting at 11 a.m. on ESPNU. ESPNU Coaches Spotlight, today at 1, only on ESPNU.
So we're back in the big house. Some happy folks wearing red. Some unhappy ones wearing maize and blue. Junior quarterback Todd Beckman, 23 years old, took over from Heisman Trophy winner Troy Smith. And the Bucks are closing in on a Big Ten championship. Michigan used a timeout. 3:30 to go.
A lot of anticipation this week about Lloyd Carr. Would this be his final game? He's been very tight-lipped about that throughout the week, which is what you'd expect from Lloyd Carr. And I don't know at the end of this game if he's going to make some kind of announcement saying that he is going to step down. But my memory of Lloyd Carr will be, forget about the Ohio State-Michigan game. It's the way he has gone about his job. He is a coach that hasn't forgotten why he got into this business. And the reason he got into this business is to build relationships between himself and his players. And when you see it behind closed doors, it's amazing to see how many people that he's affected in his time in his 13 years here as a head coach, because he takes his role as a teacher very seriously. And it's not just X's and O's in football, Brent. It's about teaching these players about life as well. And he's done a great job here in Ann Arbor.
Here's Beanie. Picks up the first down at the 30-yard line. The one point that I want to make about Lloyd is we kid about the halftime interviews, and sometimes he's a little bit of a curmudgeon to deal with. But when you talk about a class act and representing his school, yep, I totally agree with you. He's a solid football man. And no matter, this is a bum year, and Michigan fans have a right to be upset about the way it started, the way it's ending. And I don't blame him. But when you look at the whole body of work, ladies and gentlemen, it is very positive for Lloyd Carr. And that's how he should be viewed, no matter what he decides. Kirk, you and I have no inside information. I sort of think that this is it, that he'll call it a career and step away. And I think I'm going to remember it in a very positive way, like you.
Yeah, I mean, 13 years to win 5 Big Ten championships, go back to 1997, winning a national championship. And he started great against his rival Ohio State the last 6 or 7 years. It has not gone well. I just hope that the Michigan fan base realizes the entire body of work, exactly, and what he has done here and the job that he's done and the way he's gone about approaching his job with these players.
Crowds in excess of 100,000, loyal fans. The players you meet who've come through this, and we've all met them, we all run into them, and just like the Buckeye players, it's a very positive experience for the athletes. And clearly, in every way you want to measure this game, the Buckeyes have been superior today. I think they've had superior personnel. I think they've had superior play calling. And Lloyd Carr has been unable to get this team back in it.
Yeah, and I think it's fitting to give a tribute to Lloyd Carr because of what he's meant as a head coach. And it's just as fitting to recognize the job that Jim Tressel has done. But Ohio State secures this victory. I just mentioned 2002 in the BCS championship game. 2003, they went back to a BCS bowl game. 2004 or 2005, 2006, now 2007. 5 of the last 6 years, he's led Ohio State into the BCS. 2 of those games in national championship games. Right now, he's the toast of the town in Columbus, Ohio.
And the Beanie breaks free again. We've got a 200-yard rusher on our hands, folks, in a Michigan-Ohio State game.
People talk about what you do in the Ohio State-Michigan game is remembered forever. Well, Beanie Wells must have looked in the mirror and had some serious soul searching as he approached this stadium. I mentioned he said earlier this week to James Laurinaitis, who conveyed that to me, he said, James, I've got to start fast this game. So many of the games this year, I've waited until the second half to take it over. This game, I want to start fast, and you can tell his attitude was on display this afternoon.
And the first carry for his backup, Maurice Wells. Remember, Brandon Sain was in a little bit earlier. So I've got 39 carries for number 28 for 222 yards. That's a day in the office, folks.
This day will be remembered for a long time from Ohio State fans and the effort that Beanie Wells has put forth. One more carry will get him to 40 carries Talk about a workhorse. True sophomore, at the very least, comes back for one more year for Ohio State.
Final seconds. The Buckeyes will just kneel down. They're not going to try to tack one on. They don't want anything to be remembered forward. The game moves to Columbus.
Yeah, that's pretty classy of Jim Tressel to take a knee and be happy with a 14-3 victory.
So Tressel, he seeks out Lloyd Carr immediately, shakes hands. The photographers go with Lloyd. As Beanie Wells comes up and Lloyd Carr trudges off the Big House turf, a loser for the fourth time this year and the third time right here. Let's go down to Lisa with the winning coach.
Coach Tressel, team, that both offenses struggled today, but what ultimately was the difference for you guys?
Well, we ran the ball pretty well. I guess we ran it for 229 yards, and that's pretty good against a Michigan team. It's tough to come in here and win. You know, Michigan has had a lot of hard knocks this season with all the injuries and so forth, and they played with a lot of courage. Our kids played extremely hard. Awfully proud of the Buckeyes.
Chris Beanie Wells and Vernon Golston, what impressed you most about those two guys today?
Well, both those guys are playmakers. They're great kids. It was very important to them to win this football game, and we're the Big Ten champions.
All right, thanks a lot, Coach. Congratulations.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
So Jim Tressel, a winner again, now 6-1. Against the Wolverines and headed at least for Pasadena, where he'd be matched against Oregon, USC, or Arizona State. That is still to be determined. And our Chevrolet players of the game, you're looking at one of them giving a radio interview down there on tape TV. Beanie Wells, 39 carries, 222 yards. And for Michigan, we're going to highlight number 90, folks. Mr. Jamison was a load in that defensive end. 8 tackles in the defensive line, 3 of them for a loss today. And so, in honor, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund.
Coming up on Coach's Spotlight, let the speculation begin. Will Les Miles bolt Baton Rouge for Big Blue? What the distractions will mean for the Tigers? Plus, Mark Mangino and the Jayhawks prepare for the biggest football game in school history. But we'll tell you why this team could be cursed. Pete Carroll and the men of Troy still alive for the Rose Bowl. What they have to do, and if they can, make the run to Pasadena. And Lloyd Carr, stepping down, will tell you why his timing was everything and where his legacy ranks among the Michigan greats.
ESPNU Coaches Spotlight, presented by Liberty Mutual.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the show. I'm Lowell Galindo here with Coach Jim Donnan and the quarterback, Tom Luganville. We start off the spotlight by talking about Kansas-Mizzou, a battle between the number 2 and number 4 teams in the nation. Neither of these teams have ever won the Big 12 North, but one of these teams will and could go on to play in that BCS national title game. First off, Coach, how shocking is it that we're talking about Mizzou, Kansas, with national title implications?
Well, as the year has progressed, we're not that shocked, but if you would have told us back in the summer that this game might be happening, I think everybody would really kind of test whether you really had all your senses. So I think the main thing... The main thing we've seen, though, both these teams have really played with a lot of poise. They got good quarterbacks. They really have playmakers on both sides of the ball. The one thing that's really evident, though, about this Fighting Mangino team is if you look at their resume, the teams that they played, and you look at the top 25, and then you have teams that have others that got votes, they don't even play anybody that have others that got votes. I mean, they haven't played anybody in the top 30 to 35 in the country. It's not KU's fault. It's not the coach's fault. It's not the player's fault. But their schedule has been a dream schedule as far as